In today's video, I will show you how to make a 2D image into 3D using Adobe Illustrator and Cinema 4D. I will also show you how to take that 3D logo into After Effects with Element 3D. Let's begin. First, I will begin by importing my image into Adobe Illustrator. Go to File, Open, and select your image. I will use this logo illustration for this tutorial. Now, let's convert this image into a vector image. Head over to Image Trace and select this arrow to see the many options available. For this image, I will select black and white logo. There are many options for you to try, but for me, this will do. Now, I will head over to the Properties window and select Expand to make the shapes of this logo editable. Perfect! Now, if you head over to your Layers window, you can see that the logo has been separated into separate layers. We need to now remove any white backgrounds our image may have. You can see the white backgrounds by dragging your image towards the gray background. Now you can see the white background. To remove it, double-click on your image, then click and drag the white background and delete it. Do the same for the rest of the image. Perfect! We have now removed all the white backgrounds and what's left is the shape of our image. It's time to save our image. Go to File, Save As, name the file, and make sure the format is Adobe Illustrator. Select Save. A window will appear where it says Versions. We will make sure Illustrator 8 is selected and select OK. Now let us take this file to Cinema 4D. In Cinema 4D, go to File, Merge Project. Select the Illustrator file we just created and select Open. Leave the scale at 1 and select OK. An outline of our image should appear. Let me scale the image a bit. This looks good. You can see that all the layers that were in Illustrator are now in Cinema 4D. Now, to make them 3D, I will add an extrude object. Drag your logo inside the extrude object. Now nothing happened. To fix that, make sure that extrude object is selected and under its properties, we will activate the hierarchical box. Now, we will see our 2D image become 3D. I want to make the edges of my model curved and not sharp. For that, I will go to the Caps tab in the Properties menu. This menu will look different depending on which version of Cinema 4D you have. I am using Cinema 4D R23. Now, I will make sure Start Cap and End Cap are active. The size I will change to 2. You can see the edges of the model are rounded and not sharp anymore. Let me change the display to Gauss shading. You can now clearly see the outline of the model. Let me reduce the size to 1. This looks perfect to me. You have now created a 3D image from a JPEG image. However, let's say for whatever reason, you need to take your 3D model to After Effects with Element 3D. Well, let me show you. We first need to prepare it by changing one setting. Under Caps Type, we will want it to be Delaunay. This will add multiple divisions to our model, specifically to the front and back of our model. Because if we were to upload our 3D model to After Effects using Element 3D without changing that option, you will notice that the front and back of your model will have missing sections. That is why having the caps type be Delaunay is needed. Okay, I am ready now to export my 3D object as an OBJ file. Go to File, Export, and select Wavefront OBJ. I will leave these settings as is and select OK. I will name it Logo and then save it. Now let's head over to After Effects. In After Effects, create a new solid layer. Go to Layer, New, and select Solid. I will name this E3D. Let's add the Element 3D effect to this layer. Go to Effects, Video Copilot, and select Element 3D. Select Scene Setup, go to Import, and let's import the OBJ file we created. I will leave these settings as they are and select OK. This looks good now. Now select OK. Let's create a camera by going to Layer, New, and select Camera. I'll leave the settings as is and select Accept. I will frame the model into an angle that I find interesting. This looks good. Let me add some basic lighting to make the 3D model more interesting. To do that, go to Render Settings, Lighting, and under Add Lighting, select the light that you feel works with your scene. I will select Natural. I will also activate the ambient occlusion and increase the intensity. And there you have it. Today I have shown you how to create a 3D object from a JPEG image. I hope this tutorial has been useful. If you like the content, please give me a like and subscribe to the channel. See you on the next one.